The Nimble Solution Season 2 starts now. Welcome, welcome, welcome. If you're watching this video, then you probably have seen at least partial videos that I created from Season 1 of the Nimble IDE framework. I took 6 months of last year to demonstrate various prototypes, customer-facing websites, mobile applications, and various samples of what the Nimble solution can do over a six-month period with one developer part-time. So I ended that season, and I took a six-month leave so I can concentrate part-time working on one project to fully implement a solution using the Nimble framework, and I am very pleased at the outcome. Nimble blends both the use of a design tool and a programmatic event processing to create a user interface that can rapidly create single page applications for the web. But designers are nothing new to web applications. There have been tools such as Balsamiq and other wireframe UI development tools that JavaScript developers can use to, or designers, web designers can use to get requirements from the business when developing a web page or web portal. In fact, when Angular first came out, there was a tool called Polymer. And Polymer was the live web component tool that was supposed to support Angular. Now, since then, I guess the flaws in Angular have caused the two platforms to separate, and Polymer seems to be a framework all of its own, specifically designed for web components, and it seems to have separated from Angular at its core. Now, I haven't read all the details on Polymer, but it also seems to have separated from its use of a designer tool. This was the Polymer 1.0 designer tool. It allows you to drag drop elements into their designer and then set properties, very similar to what you would expect any design tool to do. It's pretty neat. I remember seeing this application, I guess, when just before I started working on Nimble, and I thought that this was going to be the next best thing. But as it started to deviate, or the issues with Angular started to come forward, this tool seemed to fade away, and I haven't seen much work done on Polymer. They did release a Polymer 2.0 recently, but I didn't notice on this website that there was never a design tool included. So I'm not sure where this project is going to go, but I do know that Polymer 2.0 has several breaking changes, and as a result, anything you did with 1.0 is probably no longer usable in 2.0. I bring that up to say that that doesn't exist on the Nimble framework. Every version that I've created with Nimble has always been compatible with new versions, and it's usually just an enhancement or additional features that I've added to the framework. So in version 4.0, it still was compatible with version 1.0, just added more features. But that's not what I'm here to talk about today. Today, I'm here to show you where I left off from season one. The idea, the concept of Nimble version 5.0. Over the past 6 months, I worked on this part-time, but in all honesty, I only could work on it for about 4 months because my wife and I bought a new house. I spent about a month to paint, lay down carpet, move into the house, get everything, you know, set up. So when you're living your life, you really don't have much time to do any side development. You just have to work. You work your regular job, and then you have to devote all your time to your family and the things that are important. So this is actually only 4.5 months worth of work that I'm going to show you today. And it's about 2 million bytes of pure JavaScript code. And I present to you Nimble version 5.0. As you can see, it looks very similar to the 4.0 version. But the difference between this and the last prototype that I showed about 6 months ago is that this baby's fully functional. If we navigate to the project, and let's say we'll open up some pre-made forms that I have to show you. You get a form layout that you can, of course, drag drop. I've added multi-select. I can take these buttons, align the right sides. Align the left. And you see the UI is very responsive in its component editing. The multi-select is very responsive, as you can see. Loading up form 3. In this view, what I want to take and highlight is the properties panel. As you can see, all the properties are now populated in the panel. You can control and set fonts, sizes, and font style. Oh, I have a breakpoint. Sorry about that. Let's disable those. And this entire IDE now has been ported to a JavaScript framework running under Electron as a desktop app, so that you will get a what you see is what you get view of what your application, your web portal will render as it's ported to a web browser, Electron, a mobile device, and a new build target. Over the few months, I was able to purchase a Chromebook, and I am in the process of designing a new output device platform for Nimble to build directly for Chromebook, the Chrome OS. So anything you build in Nimble will directly build a Chrome desktop application. Finally, if we move right along, I want you to take a quick look at the full suite of components and widgets that the Nimble version 5 supports. This will give you a look at a dialog that contains all of the components that it currently supports. The base components, labels, text box buttons, image buttons, checkbox, option buttons are fine, you know, list box. We have a progress bar, video and audio controls, image controls, panels, these were custom built, CK editor, data tables, and of course an iframe. These two components here, this was our custom joystick that we built widget, and this is the custom clock, which was created from an external site. It was ripped from an external site and wrapped as a window, as a Nimble component. This first video wouldn't be complete if I didn't recap one of my favorite features about Nimble, and that's that full stack implementation in 6 minutes. Under the REST tab, we're going to use the same random user me URL we config. We send the command, the REST service comes back with the JSON response. It's parsed within this IDE, and then I can now add that element to the dialog. The element now responds and acts like a complete object. Oops, mess up some justification there. And with the multi-select, you can select the entire object and delete it. I've taken some liberty to make the grouping ability a little bit more robust on the JavaScript side. So if I were to import the entire JSON object with grouping frames enabled, you will see the entire contract appear as an object with its hierarchy groups bound in borders. So when you move the entire user, you are moving the entire group, and all the sub-objects also move, which provides a pretty neat visualization for your JSON data object. It will allow you to create a little bit more unique layouts using the Nimble IDE. The dependencies remain so that if you move the user object, the entire group moves so that you know what is connected or related to what. Like all things in Nimble, if you can, you can multi-select a group of objects and delete them, but all the rest of the hierarchy still remains in place. Anything that you multi-select, you can copy to the system clipboard, which is also somewhat of a new feature that I've added. By pressing Control C, it's copied to the clipboard. And if you want to view the contents of the clipboard, it'll be in the standard Nimble DDT format. You can do that by simply pressing Control E. Make sure I'm in focus. Control E will export the DDT of everything you selected into a view window where you can edit it. This view window is supported by another project called Code Mirror. It does full JavaScript syntax highlighting. So if you want to add events to any dialog, such as a click event on this form, you double click and the JavaScript editor pops up with syntax highlighting enabled thanks to Code Mirror JS. The control keys, by pressing Control A, you can select all, and using the control arrow keys, you can shift groups of objects down and around on the screen with the arrow key support. Along with this port also includes stuff like the support tools, enabling a menu editor. The same way this menu system for the file edit search top menu was created, this editor allows you to recreate menus for both pop-up menus as well as dialog menus. So within the Nimble platform, this is all created within the menu editor. Here's one sample that I already have. And it just makes a script of properties that's parsed by the engine and then generates the editor, the menu system. These menu items, the top menu items that list across, support sub-menus, and sub-menus can be used to create pop-up menus like this. All the pop-up menu items are included for this form. And work perfectly within the system. So there are a number of pop-up menus throughout this entire list of properties, and they all seem to work. A new feature that I added for the Nimble platform is the message box editor. Within the Windows kernel or Windows API, there's always been the system pop-up messages, and this interface was originally for a Power Basic or Windows implementation only. So I created the message box factory, which emulates the very same pop-up message design that's included with the Windows platform. So by simply using these default parameters to say test message box, you get a Windows pop-up message. If you compare this to any standard Microsoft Windows pop-up message, it should be very similar, if not identical in the way it works. You can change the button style to OK and cancel, and you'll see you get two new buttons. You can change the icon, of course, to a critical pop-up message. And the beauty of this is that it is pretty much compatible with everything that you would do in a Windows message pop-up. You can select the button that is the default selected or has the focus. So I've selected the second button to have the focus when this pop-up message is initiated. That's why retry will be focus, has the focus. I can, of course, change the icon and generate this same pop-up message. I can view the script. Oh, let me stop there. I can view the command. This is the pop-up message command. And if you notice, it's very similar to a Windows message box command, if you have ever programmed any C++. And I can also generate the same pop-up message to parse the buttons in a select case. So when the pop-up message is executed, on confirm, it will call the on confirm command and parse the results with each button type. This is a quick way to generate pop-up menus and text pop-up message boxes within your application in a standard way. The dialog style. Under Windows, it's at a different use, so I harness this area so that you can control and generate pop-up messages in different styles. In this case, a surface pop-up where it's semi-transparent with no border. And of course, the document pop-up, which looks like a paper, piece of paper. That's the intent. So this pop-up message editor works with the message box factory that's now included in the platform. Moving right along, I've also included the area for factories, so to give you a look at the code mirror JavaScript syntax highlighter. This is a very nice JavaScript library that does syntax highlighting and allow code editing directly within the browser. It does all the highlighting. I believe there's even some autocorrect and type ahead and all the stuff that you would know or use in any type of JavaScript editor. I haven't used this heavily. I just implemented it and made sure that it was working. I'm going to add the code folding, the ability to collapse your code segments, probably when I get time. I'll turn on that feature. Last but not least is code snippets. Nimble has the ability to add code snippets. It's the same JavaScript editor, but you can also view some of the previous code snippets that were already in your library. These code snippets were Power Basic related code snippets, so the syntax highlighting does not work. I am probably going to be removing all Power Basic support from this IDE and make it completely JavaScript only. So these files will probably be either removed or replaced by JavaScript files with the equivalent code support. That all being said, this editor is probably one of the most complex JavaScript UIs I've ever worked on. It's hopefully one of the most complex UIs you've ever seen. But like I said, this is about 2 million bytes of pure JavaScript running error-free, created by one person part-time over 4 months using the Nimble framework and the builder design pattern. What can I say, guys? If you're rocking with Nimble, you're rocking with the best. It's only going to get better from here. Thank you for watching.